I've spent years talking with and learning from pastors, memory experts, and influencers about how they memorize the Bible. Everybody has their own methods and techniques, but I've noticed a pattern emerge from these conversations that provides insights into what makes them successful. What are the main habits that allow these ordinary people, people who, believe it or not, have just as good a memory as you and me, what are the habits that allow them to memorize so much of the Bible? Here's what I've found. Welcome to Bible Memory Goal. My name's Josh. And before we dive in, if you're the kind of person who wants to take that next step in your scripture memory journey, if you want to memorize more of the Bible than you ever thought possible, be sure to check out our 5-part Bible memory course where you'll learn how to train your mind to memorize faster, forget less, and build an excitement for God's word that you've never had before. Visit BibleMemoryGoal.com/training for more details. Okay, let's dive into the 5 habits employed by those who successfully memorize the Bible. Number 1, they make it a daily consistent habit. Consistency really is the key. And when I say making it a daily habit, that doesn't mean that you have to sit down for 30 minutes or an hour, although there are definitely plenty of the people that I've talked to that do that. But even just spending 5 minutes memorizing one verse or re-memorizing a verse that you did yesterday, making that a daily habit, that is what allows you to really make progress over the long haul. I mean, I've heard it said for finances, all it is compound interest. When you just break it down into what you make every single day, it's pennies. But when you add it up over time, that's what really makes compound interest when you're saving money really valuable. The same thing goes for Bible memory. If you can make that a daily habit, find a time, find a place that you do it every single time, whether it's early in the morning, whether it's during lunch, your lunchtime break, you just sit there and do it during lunch, or even right before you go to bed. You make that consistent habit something that you are always doing, and it will make a huge difference in your scripture memory. Number 2, those who are successful at Bible memory prioritize substance over storage. What do I mean by that? Well, for those who I've talked to, it's not just about how much they memorize. As a matter of fact, most people that I connect with about scripture memory are very seldom worried about how much. They're often a little bit ashamed to say how many books of the Bible that they've memorized, because what they really crave is a deeper understanding of scripture. And if you can have that, it actually supports the memory, right? You're adding an understanding that supports the memory. But more than that, it's an understanding that there's more to this than just memorizing. In the same way that it says in James 2 that the devils also believe and tremble. You know, we're talking about when James is talking to those people about, hey, just believing that Jesus and God exist is not enough, right? You've got to have more than that. Well, I would say that same thing applies here. Just memorizing scripture is not enough if you don't have that understanding to back it up. Because memorizing scripture is just one way that we can dive deeper into God's word and add substance to that storage. So those people who are good at scripture memory are those that are able to add that substance well, whether it's studying God's word while they're memorizing, or whether it's just using scripture memory as a means to go deeper into God's word. Add substance, not storage. Number 3, those who are successful at memory have made a habit of reviewing well. It's not just about sporadic memory, it's about a set system for review. I remember when I was talking to 2-time memory champion Ron White, and he said that when he was trying to understand how much he could memorize, he was trying to set this goal for himself, the thing that he didn't take into account was how much time review was going to take. And I did the same thing when I set my goal to memorize the entire New Testament. I just had no idea how much time review was going to take and how much more time it takes the more that I've memorized. So when it comes to setting your review habit, it's not about sporadically deciding, oh, I'm going to review this now. It's about having a set system to understand when you're going to review something. So I've talked about spaced repetition in the past, and that's where you're reviewing something more as it's newer. Then as time goes on and that memory becomes more settled in your brain, you don't have to review it as often, but you're still reviewing it. Right? I memorized James more than two decades ago, the book of James, and yet I still review it probably once every 4 months just to make sure that I've got that down and I don't lose that memory. Whereas, you know, I memorized 2 Timothy just last year, so I'm reviewing that probably once a month or once every 2 months. Having that set system of memory is what's going to really help you not just memorize, but maintain these memories of God's word for the long haul. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I'm not memorizing just for the sake of memorizing. I'm memorizing for life. I want this to be in my heart. I want this to be the last thing that goes in my memory. When I have Alzheimer's and I forget who my, you know, grandkids are, I still want to remember what I memorized of the Bible. Now, these next two habits are what separate those who get burned out from scripture memory after a short while from those who are able to maintain it for their entire lives. So listen carefully. Number four, they're intentional about meditation. Now, I'm drawing a line here between review and meditation because I do think they're different. I don't know about you, but I can review something, just say the words, sometimes checking what I'm saying, without actually meditating on it. I'm sure you've done that as well, right? We just say the words, but we don't meditate on it. Meditating on it is letting that scripture, that passage of scripture, soak in, trying to understand what it is that God's using that passage to speak to me about. And one of the reasons I love memorizing is because it allows me to meditate anywhere at any time. Whether I'm laying in my bed and I can't go to sleep, or I'm driving my car and I can't actually look down at a Bible, I can meditate on God's word because I've memorized it. But that doesn't necessarily mean that whenever I'm reviewing, I'm meditating. So being intentional about meditation is making sure that you're not just spending time reviewing, but you're also spending time meditating. Maybe that is breath prayers. I've talked about breath prayers before. Or maybe that is just deciding that, you know, once a week or one time out of your day, you're just going to sit and repeat a verse a number of times and let God just speak to you through that verse. What is it that he wants to say to you through that verse that you've memorized? Be intentional about meditating on what you've memorized. Number five, and this one is huge. Everybody I know who's been successful at scripture memory has taken time to rest. That means having a period every week when they rest. Maybe sometimes every month. I've talked to some people who rest on an annual basis. After a year or after a few years, they'll take some time off. For me, sometimes I'll finish a book and then I'll take a period of rest. Rest doesn't mean I'm not opening my Bible. It just means that I'm not setting goals for myself where I have to memorize more. Maybe I'll just review. Maybe I'll just spend that more time on meditation like we talked about in number four. But rest is important. If you were to talk to somebody who, let's say, ran a marathon and they're training for that marathon, and what they describe to you how they trained that marathon, I've done this in the past and I can promise you that nobody is training 7 days a week. Or if they are, they're probably doing themselves a disservice. People train and train hard for 5 or 6 days out of the week, but then they take that one day of rest. And that one day of rest is biblical. God talks about resting on the seventh day, and he encouraged the Israelites to rest, not just themselves, but also their land. And when it comes to scripture memory, it helps and it benefits you to take that rest, because if you're just pushing yourself too hard, that is just a recipe for burnout. And I've seen it too many times in other people, and I've felt it honestly in myself, where I've had to take a period of rest here in 2023 because I went hard in 2021 and 2022, and I was feeling the burnout coming on strong. And so I needed to take that rest. And that was important for me. And that's important for you too, to recognize that rest is not failure. Rest is something that is God-given. It is a gift, and it's something that you need to take and you need to use and make sure that that becomes part of your scripture memory journey as well. Those are the five habits that I've begun to incorporate into my own scripture memory journey. If you have others that you want to add, go ahead and put them in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. If you want more great tips on memorizing scripture, you can watch one of these two videos here. Have a great week, and God bless.